Hi friends, it's been quite a few days since we all went into quarantine and we have not been able to continue our regular lectures. This is my attempt to bring to you a few video sessions through which we are going to revise topics, and in this first video we are going to revise spotting errors. So without wasting any time, let's continue.
Well, let's revise from the beginning. Spotting errors on English grammar are based on various topics of grammar such as noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, articles, syntax, etc. As you know, out of all these topics, the most important is verb. In verb, there are many subtopics such as subject-verb agreement, tense, voice, then gerund and gerund, infinitive, past participle, and many more. So we must learn this lesson in detail. We already learnt it, but we are going to revise a few things now. Let's have a look at the nature of question. As you all know, every question has a sentence which is split into three parts, and they are labeled as A, B, and C. If you find a grammatical error in any of the three parts, you will have to mark that answer in the answer sheet which is provided to you. And if you don't find any error in the question, you will have to answer D, which stands for no error. Now let's look at some solved questions. In the first question here, the poetries, the word poetries is used in plural, whereas it should not be used in plural because it is an uncountable noun. Poetry is an uncountable noun, that's why it has no plural form. So the error is in part A. In the second question, the pronoun one is used. One means anyone. It's an indefinite pronoun. Here, a definite pronoun he or she are not used. Okay. Or I. It is also not used. So, the teacher said to the boys that one ought to work hard. One ought to work hard means anyone ought to work hard. The poet is not talking about a particular person. That's why it is an indefinite pronoun. And the possessive form of this pronoun is used incorrectly as his. In place of his, we need to use ones. Ones living. So the first question deals with an error in the use of noun, and the second question deals with an error in the use of a pronoun. So we'll have to look at such kind of errors in the questions. Now let's have a look at some rules for you identifying spotting errors. The first rule is, when two or more than two singular nouns are connected by and. Here Ram is a singular noun and Hari, these are two singular nouns which are connected by and. When two singular nouns are connected by and, we usually take a plural verb, okay? But in the first sentence, the verb is, that's why it is incorrect. And in the second sentence, we have used are. So Ram and Hari is here. This is inappropriate grammatically. So the correct answer is Ram and Hari are here. When two singular nouns are joined by and, we'll have to use a plural verb, okay? Then the next question, rule, when two singular nouns refer to the same person or thing. For example, here secretary is a singular noun and principal is a singular noun. When two singular nouns refer to only one person, now how do we identify that singular nouns are used for only one person? We identify from the use of the article, the definite article the. We can see here that the definite article the is used before the first singular noun, secretary. It is not repeated after the second singular noun. So here we understand that we are talking about the same person, the secretary and the principal. These are not different persons, okay? And if this definite article is repeated after this and before the second noun, it means we are talking about two different people. If you say the secretary and the principal, here in this case we are talking about two people having both of them playing different roles. One is secretary and the other is principal. But in this case, the article is not repeated, that's why we are talking about only one person. Both of the roles are being played by only one person. That's why when two singular nouns refer to the same person, the verb should be singular. And in the first sentence, R is used, that's why it's incorrect. And in the second sentence, is used, that's why it is correct. The correct answer is, the secretary and principal is coming. Now, let's look at other rules. Rule number 3 and rule number 4. In rule number 3, it is said that if we use each or every before a singular noun, we always take a singular verb. If you look at the first example, boy is a singular noun, girl is also a singular noun, and they are joined by and. And before the first singular noun, every is used. And the rule says that when we use every before a singular noun, the verb should be singular. And in the first sentence, the verb where is used, that's why incorrect. And in the second sentence, was is used, that's why it is correct. When every is used before a singular noun, the verb should always be singular. And the rule number 4 says that when two or more than two singular nouns or subjects are connected by or, nor, either or, neither nor. When do we use either or, neither nor? When we are talking about two people or two things and not both of them collectively. When we are talking about two people individually, we use or, nor. It means we are talking about this or that, not both of them collectively. So in this case, the verb should be singular. Okay. So in the first example, we are talking about he, she, he and I, okay. And the conjunction that is used here is neither nor. Means neither he nor I, where is incorrect here, we'll have to use was, which is correct one. That's why the second example is correct. Now, let's look at rule number 5 and 6. When the subject joined by or, nor, are of different numbers. Here number means singular or plural. When we use nor, either, neither nor, either or, and one subject is singular and the other subject is plural, the verb should be plural. Okay. In the first example, neither the assistant masters, here assistant masters is a plural subject and nor is used after it. And after nor, a singular noun is used. Okay. The first noun is plural, assistant masters, and the second noun is singular, the headmaster. Here was is incorrect because we are not talking about one person. And there is one more part of this rule, that when two nouns with different numbers are used, the plural noun should be used later than the singular noun. Means the singular noun should come first. That's why the first sentence is incorrect. And in the second sentence, we can see that the singular noun, the headmaster, is used earlier than the plural noun, the assistant masters. And the plural verb is used where. Means when one or more than one nouns are used, and one is in singular number and the other is in plural number, the verb must be plural. And in this case, the plural noun should come after. Okay, here where is used and the plural noun is used just adjacent to the verb, means after the singular noun it is used, and they are joined by neither nor. Okay, this way the rule number 5 is also over. Now we are going to learn rule number 6. When the subjects joined by or, nor are of different persons. In the earlier rule we learned of subjects which are of different numbers, singular number or plural number. Here we are talking about subjects having different persons. You know there are three persons, first person, second person and third person. I is a first person pronoun, he is a third person pronoun and you is a second person pronoun. In the first example, you can see that he is a third person pronoun and I is a first person pronoun, okay? And with I, we don't use is. We don't say I is mistaken. We say I am mistaken, okay? And when the subject is joined by are, nor, are of different person, the verb agrees in person with the one nearest to it. Here, let's see in this case, either he or I is mistaken. This is incorrect. Either he or I am mistaken. This is correct because am, this verb, agrees with this pronoun, which is just adjacent to it, just the nearest to it. Okay. Now rule number 7 and 8. In rule number 7, we can see that a collective noun is talked about. When a collective noun is used, the verb can be either singular or plural. Okay. A collective noun takes a singular verb, or it can also take a plural verb. But the context must be different. Collective noun, you know, is a group of people or things. When the group of people, members of that group are behaving as members of one group, they have a kind of unity, they have a kind of oneness of opinion. We mean that the subject is singular. We can see in the first example, the council. Here, council is a collective noun, which is the council is having many members. It is a group of members. Okay. So the council has chosen the president. Here, they have done the action of choosing. They have chosen the president. It means that they unanimously have done this. Okay. They did not have different opinions and they have chosen it. That's why the council has chosen it. It is the council is considered here as a singular noun because the members of that group are behaving as group members of one group. They are having oneness of opinion. Okay, this is why it is considered as a singular noun and a singular verb is used, and that's why it is an appropriate use. And this, in the second example, we can see that the jury against the bail. The jury is a collective noun. Which is a jury means a group of judges. And in this example, after this collective noun, a plural verb is used. And this is also correct because in this case, we can see that it is just implied that some members of the jury were in support and others were in opposition. That's why all members of the group were not having oneness of opinion. That's why it is considered as a plural noun. A collective noun can be considered as a singular noun, and a singular verb can be used when they are having oneness of opinion. And when they are not having oneness of opinion, the collective noun is considered plural and a plural verb is used. So this is rule number 7. And in rule number 8, we can see that some nouns which are plural in form but singular in meaning. Here mathematics seems to be plural, but it is not having a plural meaning. Okay, that's why we cannot use a plural verb. We must use a singular verb. So mathematics are is incorrect because here mathematics is one subject. We are not talking about more than one thing. Okay, when this word means calculation, mathematics has two meanings. When we use it as a singular, it means it is a subject. Okay. And when we use it as plural, it means calculations. For example, we can say that his mathematics were wrong. It means his calculations were wrong. In this case, we are using it as a plural noun to say calculations, to mean it calculations. In this context, we can use a plural verb with mathematics, but here, when we say mathematics, as a subject, it is singular noun, and a singular verb should be used here with this noun. That's why the second one is correct and the first one is incorrect. Okay. Now rule number 9 and 10. In rule number 9, we can see that words joined to a singular subject. Here, the chief with all his army men. Okay. Army men is a plural noun. Okay. Men. We are not talking about only one man. It is men, a plural noun. Okay. And the chief. The chief is a singular noun. When words joined to a singular noun with, together with, in addition to, okay, as well as, etc. Or along with also. Along with. For example, we can say the commander along with his soldiers. Okay. The commander along with his soldiers. Or if we can also use as well as the commander as well as his soldiers. Okay. When we join a singular noun and a plural noun with as well as, in addition to, together with, okay, along with, we must use a singular noun, singular verb. Here in the first example, where is used, which is incorrect, and in the second example, was is used, which is correct. Here in this case, the verb does not agree with both of the nouns collectively. It agrees with only the first noun, okay, which is singular. When they are joined by, together with, in addition to, as well as, or along with. Remember these four points. When a singular noun and a plural noun are joined by, together with, in addition to, along with, or as well as, the verb should be singular. Okay, because it does not agree with both of the nouns collectively. It agrees with only the first noun, which comes before, along with, in addition to, together with, or as well as. So this is the rule. And rule number 10 says that when the subject of the verb is a relative pronoun, care should be taken to see that the verb agrees in number and person with the antecedent of the relative. What is antecedent? Antecedent is a noun which comes before relative noun. Here in the first example, you can see that I, who is your friend? Okay. Here, who is a relative pronoun which is used before this pronoun? Or a noun, it can also be noun. Okay. For example, Rohan, who is your friend? Okay. Rohan is a third person singular noun. That's why is appropriate here. But in this case, I is not a third person pronoun. That's why we cannot use is with I. We'll have to use am. I, who am your best, who am your friend. Okay. So this is who is a relative pronoun which is used as the subject of the verb. Okay. What is the verb here? Am is the verb, and its subject is this relative pronoun. When relative pronoun is working as the subject of the verb, we should take care that the verb agrees in number and person with the antecedent of the relative. What is the antecedent of this relative pronoun? Here, I is the antecedent of this relative pronoun, and the verb should agree with this pronoun in number and person. In number means, if it is singular, the verb should be singular. If it is plural, the verb should be plural. Okay. Here, am we have used, it is singular, and the antecedent is also singular. That's why it is correct. And another point is person. I is first person, and am is also first person. That's why this is correct. But in the first example, I is first person, is third person verb. That's why the first example is incorrect and the second example is correct. Now let's look at a few practice examples. When I offered him to help, whenever we offer something, don't use a verb. Okay. Here after offer him, a verb is used to help. Don't use a verb before offer. Offer plus verb, it is an incorrect combination. So after the verb offer, we need to use a noun. Offer plus noun. What is the noun form of to help? The noun form of to help is just help. Help is a noun form. It can also be used as a verb form, but in this case it is a noun form. Okay. When I offered him help, which he needed. Okay. What did I offer him? I offered him help. Okay. We should use a noun form. Okay. So that's why the error is in part B. In place of to help, it should be only help. So this to is unnecessary. Remember this thing. After the verb offer, we should not use a verb. It is incorrect. Okay. Verb is incorrect. So it should be a noun, which is correct. So in this case, the answer is option B. In the second example, I have lost a pen which I bought yesterday. Okay. Which pen have I lost? I have lost a particular pen. Okay. After this noun, a modifier is used, a modifying clause is used. Which I bought yesterday is a clause which modifies the meaning of this noun. It's a modifier. It's a modifying what we call a clause, because it begins with a conjunction. There is a subject, there is a verb. That's why it is a clause. Okay, what is a clause? Clause is a combination of a subject and a finite verb. Here a subject is used, a finite verb is used. That's why it is a clause. And this clause is modifying the meaning of this noun. It is making it definite. We are not talking about any pen in general. We are talking about a particular pen which I bought yesterday. Okay. That's why here in place of a, we should use the. Because the is a definite article. When we talk about a particular person or particular thing, we should use a definite article, not an indefinite article. Okay. So in this example, in place of a, we should use the. That's why the error is in part A. Okay. Now, let's look at example number 3 and 4. In example number 3, it is said that he said, and everybody agreed with him, that beast in man is responsible for great cruelties. Okay. Here in this example, before the word beast, there should be the. That the beast in man, we are not talking about any beast in general. We are talking about a particular beast, the beast in man, jo insaan ke andar jo janwar hota hai, us janwar ke baare mein hum baat kar rahe hain. We are not talking about any other beast in general. Okay, we are talking about a particular beast which resides in man. Okay, that's why the definite article is required here. That's why the error is in part B. Part B starts here. This is part A and this is part C. And in case if there isn't any error, the answer should be D. Okay, but in this case the error is here. The beast in man should be there. Okay, so this is an error related with the use of an article. Okay, now rule number 4. In rule number 4 it is said that Paradise Lost is one of those world's epics which have carved out. Paradise Lost is the name of an epic. Whenever we are talking about an epic or any other religious book, okay, we must use the before it. So this is also an error related with the use of article. Okay, remember this point, that before the names of religious books, before the names of epics, before the names of newspapers, before the names of mountain ranges, before the names of oceans, rivers, gulfs, seas, bays, straits or geographical entities, etc., we use the. Okay, before the names of directions also we use the. In this case, Paradise Lost is a book. It is not a general book. Okay, it is an epic. Epics are unique things. Okay, there are many other epic. There are many epics, but epic is a kind of special book, as we have religious books. Religious books are also have religious books or holy books of religions. For example, we don't say Quran, we say the Quran. We don't say Bible, we say the Bible. We don't say Bhagavad Gita, we say the Bhagavad Gita. The should be there before the religious books or holy books of religions. In the same way, before the names of epics, we use the. Okay, so here also the error is in the use of articles. Now let's look at example number 5 and 6. In example number 5, it is said that he saw many deers, D-E-A-R-S, running along the river banks. Okay, one of them rally. He saw many deers. What is the correct spelling of deer? D-E-E-R, not deer, D-E-A-R. Deer means someone who is lovable to someone else. Okay, deer is D-E-E-R is the correct spelling. And one more thing, the noun deer can be used as a singular and it can also be used as plural. It doesn't have a form which takes S in the end. Okay, so the plural of deer is deer itself. The plural of deer is not deers, D-E-E-R-S or D-E-A-R-S. Both of them are incorrect plurals. Okay, so the plural of deer is deer. Okay, so the error is in the use of noun, which is a kind of plural noun. Okay, whenever we are making a noun plural, we should follow the rules of making plural. Okay, so these are the rules of pluralization of noun. So the error is in the part of noun in part A. Now let's look at example number 6. In example number 6, it is said that the man and his horse. Here we are not talking about an object. Here we are talking about man and an animal. Horse is also an animal. When we are talking about a person or an animal, we don't use which. In place of which, we should use that. Okay. When do we use which? When we are talking about an object. Okay. For example, we can say, the book which you gave me yesterday. We cannot say the book that you gave me yesterday. Okay. The book which, because book is an object. Here in this case, man and horse, these are not objects. That's why we cannot use which. We should use that in place of which. Okay. So this is an error related with the use of a relative pronoun. Here which is a relative pronoun and its antecedent nouns are man and horse. Okay, so the antecedent of which is matters a lot. The antecedent of which must be an object, and if it is not an object, if it is the name of an animal or a man or a person, it should be that in place of which. So let's look at next examples. Example number 7. Neither of those 5 boys. When we are talking about more than 2 boys, okay, here we are talking about 5 boys. When we are talking about more than 2 boys, we cannot use either, neither. Okay, when do we use either, neither? When we are talking about 2 people or 2 things and not about them collectively. When we are talking about 2 people or things individually, we use either or neither. When we are talking about more than 2 people or things, we cannot use neither either. So the error is in this part, in part A. Okay. So next example number 7. In this example, it is said that he didn't do anything. He fed himself. See, what is the use of reflexive pronoun? When do we use reflexive pronoun? Reflexive pronoun is used with typical verbs. For example, he absented himself, absent, with the verb absent we can use a reflexive pronoun. He is a nominative case pronoun. When we use the verb absent with he, we should use the reflexive pronoun himself. He absented himself. He is a nominative case pronoun and himself is a reflexive pronoun. Okay, so with this verb, with this particular verb, we use a reflexive pronoun. And what are other verbs with which we use reflexive pronouns? Avail, okay, A-V-A-I-L. I availed the opportunity myself, okay. Or there are some other verbs also in this category which you all know. The verbs also include adopt, A-D-A-P-T. For example, we must adapt ourselves to the local circumstances, okay. Adapt, we is a pronoun in nominative case. When we use this verb after this nominative case pronoun, the reflexive pronoun should also follow. We, what is the reflexive pronoun of we? It's ourselves, okay. So the reflexive pronoun must be used with a few typical verbs, and in this case the reflexive pronoun is used with fed, okay, and it is incorrect. With feed or fed, we don't use a reflexive pronoun, okay. So remember this point, this is an incorrect use of reflexive pronoun, that's why the error is in part B. Now let's look at rule number 9 and 10. Example number 9 and 10. Example number 9 says that I have already expressed my desire that between you and I there should be no formality. Okay. I have already expressed my desire that between you and I. Whenever we use a preposition, between is a preposition. Remember this point. Whenever we use a preposition, after a preposition, the pronoun should be in the objective case, not in the nominative case. Okay. Here you can be nominative as well as objective. Okay. But I is incorrect. In place of I, we should use me. Me is an objective case pronoun. Okay. So after a preposition, the pronoun which is used should not be a nominative case pronoun. Here I is a nominative case pronoun, and that's why it is incorrect. In place of I, we'll have to use me, which is a pronoun in the objective case. Okay. So remember the point, I'll repeat it. After a preposition, the pronoun should be in the objective case. It should not be in the nominative case. Okay. Now example number 10, the last example in this episode. There were 10 women passengers. It's a print mistake. I will tell you. This is not a grammatical mistake. This is just a typing mistake. There were 10 women passengers in the cabin. Okay. Just don't consider this as a grammatical mistake. I will tell you that this is a typing mistake. There were 10 women passengers in the cabin. They all quarreled with each other. How many women were there? 10. Means more than 2. When we are talking about more than 2 people, we don't use each other. Remember this point. Each other is incorrect when we are talking about more than 2 people. When we are talking about more than 2 people, we must use one another. One another. Okay. When we are talking about 2 people, we use each other. When we are talking about more than 2 people, we use one another. 10 people quarreled with one another, not each other. So these were some of the examples that we have solved today. Now I will give you a task. I will suggest you to make groups. Whenever you are studying, you should make buddies. What do you mean by buddy? Buddy is a close friend. BUDDY. Buddy is a close friend with whom you spend most of your time. Okay. And with whom your frequency matches. So everyone has a buddy and must have a buddy. Okay, because that buddy, your buddy will help you, assist you in solving your problems. That buddy will help you in many of the things in study. So make a list of your buddies, okay, one or two, okay, or more, or it can be more than two also, okay. So I would suggest you to make a list of prepare a group, a brainstorming group. We can make it short BSG, brainstorming group. Make a BSG. For example, Rohan is a student and his buddy is Deepak. Just I'm taking imaginary names. Rohan, Deepak and Hitesh. These are three best buddies who always spend their most of the time with one another. We are not talking about two people, we are talking about two of them, more than two. That's why we cannot use each other, okay? As we have just learned this rule. So there should be such buddies, and you will have to make such brainstorming groups, and you can discuss things or the rules or the examples that we regularly study, or any other subject that you study. This kind of brainstorming group will help you a lot in your preparation and keeping up your confidence level. Okay, so this is a best suggestion I would recommend you. And at last, I would suggest you to visit my website, which is shatakshitutorials.com. Okay, my website is shatakshitutorials.com. So visit my website, and on this website you will find some useful articles on grammatical topics. Presently I have uploaded a topic on noun, and in this chapter you will find every important detail about the use of a noun, and this chapter will help you a lot in your study of competitive examinations. And in the upcoming days I am going to upload many other topics, chapters also. And you can also find a PDF of this chapter, and you can easily download the PDF, okay? And you can share this, subscribe this channel, and
so that's all for today. And in our next lecture, we are going to learn many more rules of spotting errors and many more example sentences of spotting errors. And don't forget to visit the website, which is given at the end of this video, and subscribe to our channel and share it. Thank you and have a nice day.